The SWEAP investigation consists of three separate instruments and a central electronics box. Most of the instruments within SWEAP sit on either side of the spacecraft, stare out over the entire sky, and make maps of all the different particles and what energies they're moving at, and what types of particles they are. The purpose of SWEAP is to measure the bulk of the solar wind and the solar atmosphere. One of the biggest questions we want to resolve with Solar Probe is how the corona and the solar wind are heated. In order to do that, we need to see if there are waves that are coming from the sun and depositing energy within the solar atmosphere and in the solar wind. So we have a series of sensors across the spacecraft that will collect individual particles, electrons, fully ionized hydrogen and helium, which we call protons and alphas, and other minor ions, and make maps of the number of particles as a function of their speed and energy and type. We take those maps on the ground, and we can interpret them to figure out the temperature, the density, the pressure of the solar wind and the solar atmosphere. On the RAM side of the spacecraft, so that's in the shadow of the heat shield, in the direction that Solar Probe is moving around the sun, we have Span A. Span A looks ahead of the spacecraft. It has an electron and an ion instrument, and they can see the entire sky on that side of the spacecraft. On the other side, the anti-RAM side of the spacecraft, we have Span B, which basically looks behind our direction of motion. Span A and Span B are each able to take an inventory of electrons coming from any direction in the sky. And their fields of view stitch together like the seams on a baseball. The spans combine to give us a field of view that covers nearly the entire sky, but we have one large gap in our field of view, and it's produced by the heat shield at the front of the spacecraft. So we have the Solar Probe Cup as the final instrument within SWEAP. The Solar Probe Cup sits on a strut. It looks around the heat shield and faces directly into the sun. When our solar wind or solar atmosphere comes blowing into the cup, if those particles, which are charged, don't have enough energy, they get reflected out by that electric field we've set up. The particles with enough energy to make it past the electric field come in and strike a plate, and we record the current. All we have to do in an individual measurement is sweep in voltage and measure the number of particles that can make it in as a function of voltage. That sweep, when we interpret it, lets us figure out the average speed, direction, energy, temperature, density of individual populations of particles.